Coasters are meant to be fun, but some of them bring the pain. But did you know that you could hurt every single part of your body on a coaster? If you've ridden enough coasters, you'll find this to be the case. From head to toe, I've gathered a list of the coasters that will cause the most pain to each part of your body. Let's start off with the feet, and that's B&M stand-up coasters, especially on the big ones that pull a lot of G's at the bottom of their big drops and inversions, Riddler's Revenge and Green Lantern. The forces will push down on you so hard that you really feel it in your feet. Usually those high G moments are dispersed a little bit more on your butt and your feet when you're sitting down on a normal coaster, but all of that force on your feet is a little much. I also really feel those forces in my calves. It almost feels like they're gonna start cramping up when they dial up the positive G's. Amusement Insiders had a horror story about his legs on Green Lantern, and I could definitely believe it. But stand-up coasters are not the most brutal on your calves. That honor goes to X2 on that final Raven turn and the flip into the brake run. Especially in the back row, your calves start bouncing around and there's not much that you can do about it. It would be nice to have something to brace your legs on this part, but I usually just stick them straight out to avoid all the calf banging. Moving on to the shins. There's only one ride that comes to mind here, Coast Rider at Knott's. Those shin guards were installed in 2017, and for anyone who's riding and is not a kid, these things will dig right into your shins for the whole ride. The ride isn't good as it is, but with the shin guards, it just makes it unpleasant. Next up are the thighs, and that's also an easy one. Thigh Crush, Sky Rush at Hershey Park. During those intense negative G moments, you get some immense pain in the thighs. This is some of the more serious pain that you'll get on this list. Some people are okay with this ride, and I really wish that I could be also, but I'm not. Moving on to your butt. This is actually the best kind of pain that you'll get on a coaster because it always comes after a great airtime moment. The ones that come to mind are Diamondback at Kings Island, Steel Eel at SeaWorld San Antonio, and Coaster at Playland. All of these coasters seem to lift you out of your seat and then slam you back down violently at the bottom of those hills. For all the guys out there, I won't go into too much detail. I'll just say T3 at Kentucky Kingdom and SNS Free Spins if you don't staple yourself. You have been warned. How about the stomach? This one's a little hard to judge, so I'm just thinking of coasters that really make me nauseous. Some people would say SNS Free Spins or spinning coasters in general, but for me, it's those really rough coasters that do it. When I was in high school, I would get a big bowl of chili cheese fries and then ride Cyclone at Magic Mountain, the old rough din coaster that lasted from 1991 to 2006. And sometimes I would be in so much stomach pain afterward that I could not take it. If you have a personal experience with stomach pain on a coaster, let me know in the comments below. Moving up to the ribs. This honor goes to Desperado at Buffalo Bills Resort and Casino. This thing has brutal transitions, and it goes so fast that it'll fling you to the side of the car at the expense of your ribs. The more you ride it, the more you feel it. Also, shout out to that final turn on Pegasus at Mount Olympus. Without bracing for this moment, your head, neck, and ribs will all be destroyed. I did brace for it, and the main thing I tried to protect was my ribs. Now let's talk about the torso as a whole. This dishonor goes to X-Flight at Six Flags Great America. And it's all thanks to those B&M vest restraints. I really don't like how these come down throughout the ride, and by the time you hit that brake run, you're really feeling like it's trying to crush you. If they're stacking trains, and you're stuck on the brake run for a long time, that's no fun at all. I've ridden a lot of coasters with the vest restraint, but X-Flight is the one that bothered me the most. How can you possibly hurt your hands on a coaster? I jammed my thumb really bad on Mako at SeaWorld Orlando, and it happened a few times, always at the same moment. The airtime hill going into the mid-course brake run. I always hang onto the restraint to keep it from coming down throughout the ride. And during this moment, as you're flying into the brake run, you're out of your seat. But the brakes slow you down, and that thrusts your body forward, and unfortunately, thrusts my thumb right into the lap bar.
Ow!
This only happens when you have your hands down. So what about you hands up riders? Some older rides don't have the best clearances. I've heard stories of some people who are more on the tall side whacking a support with their hands. It's never happened to me, but it definitely can happen, especially with older coasters. Moving up to the shoulders. This next coaster is a problem for us tall people. I'm talking about Aero Loopers. Some people may not like how these bang your head around, but for me, those restraints really dig into your shoulders by the end of the ride. I've been sitting on the final brake run of Viper, trying to slink down in my seat to relieve the tension on my shoulders. Also, honorable mention, the ejector airtime on RMC Raptors with those shoulder straps can cause some bruising also. Onto the neck. And there has never been a bigger neck banger than the Big Apple Coaster at New York, New York Hotel and Casino in Vegas. They have those horrible shoulder restraints that sit right by your neck, and every time you hit a janky Togo transition, your neck flies right into them. Especially if you're not in the front. It's hard to see when those transitions are coming, so you're pretty helpless. The most prolific source of pain on a coaster is the head. So many coasters are guilty of head banging, and others are so rough and bumpy that it'll jiggle your brain around. But the worst of the worst headbangers is Time Warp at Canada's Wonderland. This was just non-stop, side to side, head slamming into the restraint. And since you're laying down on your stomach, it's hard to brace your head for it. So it's basically torture the whole ride. If you know a bigger headbanger than this, let me know in the comments below. Let's end this video with the eyes. There are some awful color schemes out there, but I'm not talking about those. This one goes to all of the coasters where you pass through the on-ride photo on a night ride. The one that comes to mind for me is Full Throttle. After that loop, you pass by the on-ride photo section and you're blinded until you hit the dive loop. It can't be good for your eyes, but at least they're selling some on-ride photos. That's all for this video, because I have run out of body parts to talk about. So let me know what you think of these choices, and if there's any other parts of the body that you can think of, like toes, ears, or fingernails, let me know in the comments below which coasters cause that kind of pain based on your experience. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.